So we're just going to get the horses in now. Well, it's Solomon we've had since he was 15 months. And Mercy we've just had for... What about this gate here? What about this gate to the lane? What about the gate to the lane, kids? Right, I'll shut it then. I'm just going to shut the lane gate. Kids fighting in the background. No, and so anyway, with the land that we've got, well, we haven't got it, it's a farmer's land around here. It's over 40 acres, and I can't show you all of it because it stretches for miles and miles. So getting these horses out of over 40 acres, I don't know, it's about 60 or 80, something like that, is, I just would, if you had to go and get them, you'd spend ages just hunting them down. There's two of them, so you'd have halters as well, and you'd have to bring two of them in. So anyway, but this is why we've got to get them to come to us. So Solomon's not too much of a problem because he was 16 months old when we got him. He had not much contact with people at that point, so you couldn't get him then. But having formed a bond with him, he'll come now. It's going to be quite loud when I whistle because it's going to be one of those penetrating high whistles. Not just a, so just close your ears for a minute. Now I can see them in the distance. And first one to come galloping in should be Solomon at the front here. Oh, that could be Mercy. Now, if Solomon wasn't there at the moment, probably we wouldn't be able to get Mercy to come in. Although she is, he's actually training her up. He is the first one in normally, he's coming now. And it would be more difficult to get her without him, but she comes to the whistle now after 4 months because he's basically taught her to do this. So he's coming in now, and I'll back up a bit in a minute, and the kids will get behind the door of the stables, please. Open the gates. So Joel's going to open the gates. I'm going to handle the camera still. And we've got them both coming in here. I've got one kid behind... I've got just Joel behind one of the doors at the moment. They normally both stand behind a door, so whichever one goes in first. But Bethany's gone off somewhere. Solomon, hello darling. Off he goes because he knows where to go. And here comes Mercy, and she's going, hopefully. Although it's going to get mixed up because nobody's helping at this end. Well, get Sally in quickly, shut his door very quickly so Mercy can't go in. Shut it now. That's it. Right, good girl, Mercy. She's going to wait for hers to be opened. Come on. Mercy. Come on, baby. Come on. Good girl. She's going to go round me. She's going to go in. Come on, in you go. Come on, in you go, girl. She says, oh no, I'm going to go back into the field. That's right, just go and shut the gate and then she can't go back that way. She's just having a look round. She's not totally... She says, no, I'm going to go in my stable after all. Yeah. That's it. Here you go. And there we go. That was getting them out of... at least those two fields together, at least 40 acres. And Solly's... He's actually a low boy. You good boy? It's getting colder as well. He's losing a bit of weight now because he's in at night and he's like turning his nose up at his hay. And so is she, actually. Although the hay is decent hay, so I don't know why they're not. But anyway, she needs to lose weight. Solomon doesn't. So I'm just going to switch the camera off now while I groom them. And thank you, Joel. So we've got both the kids grooming Mercy here, as they wanted me to film them grooming Mercy. She needs a good brushing.
As you can see,
pull out a bit so we can get her rolling.
As you can see, this horse Mercy is very beautiful. How are you, Mercy? She just needs a bit sorted out on her bone.
She does.
This one's a cow.
She needs a good brush. Actually getting a winter coat now if I just move down this way, because she's not looking this way at all. She's getting all furry.
She's a very good girl. Most of the time I miss.
You're getting all furry, Mercy. She gets a winter coat.
I ride on her most of the time. She's very fluffy. Very
fluffy. Solomon, just come say hello. Hello, Solly. He's rubbing his face on trees. His face will go black soon because he's slowly getting his winter coat, and he goes from a lovely buckskin colour, and then he goes very, very dark in the winter as he gets his winter coat. But that bit on his face, there, you've been rubbing, haven't you, from gnats and flies, and he's still doing it now. He says, I'm going to have a good rub on this door again now. Yeah.
This is the other one. Good boy.
And he's rubbed most of his mane out.
A bit more.
So we've had to
stop rolling.
Had to pull it a bit, which is a shame because it was all different colours. But he spent most of the summer with nasty sweet itch, which we've sprayed him with fly spray and sprayed him.
And this is
still has a reaction to fly bites. She's not too bad. She's still scratching herself a bit this year. The flies have been really bad this summer because it's been quite hot here. It's not normally that hot in the UK, but this year it's been quite bad. Well, it's been lovely, but as far as flies have been concerned, they've been all over the place.
You see, he's got quite some marks on
here. Yeah, they're growing again now. It is growing, it's growing very fast. Not his is, yours is growing, isn't it, Solly? But not as fast as Mercy's. Hey, I can get up to you. I can't get you in the picture.
But he's just got to learn a bit more, less riding. What happened to his face, Mum?
He's been rubbing it. He's going dark. You notice he's going dark now. It's changing colour. So he says, I'm still itchy, even though it's getting cooler. It is colder today. Come on then, you're supposed to be brushing Mercy. I'll brush him in a minute. Bethany, come on. There she is, get on with her. Make her nice and beautiful. Oh, confetti.
Thank you.
Yeah, beautiful as you are.
Yeah, I'll switch this off now and then we can get on with it.